All right, so the next thing I want to talk about are the descriptive statistics of variability. So remember, variability tells us how spread out a group of scores is, how spread out a data set is. And there's two primary measures of variability. One is called the variance. The other one's called a standard deviation. And so a standard deviation is approximately the average distance of scores from the mean. It's not exactly that. It's conceptually that's kind of what it is. So what I actually wrote here, let's do, for example, let's say we have a data set, and we have three data points in this case, 1, 1, and 4. Right, so we could actually draw this out. So here we got 2, 1, 2, number ones, and we got 1, 4. All right, so we need to know what the mean is for this. So 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 divided by 3, the mean is 2. So that is where the mean is. So the average distance score of scores from the mean, well, let's see here. A distance score is how far a score is. So the mean is 2, and this score here is a 1, so it's 1 away. This score up here is also 1 away from the mean. And this one over here is a 4, so 4 is 1, 2. It's 2 away from the mean. All right, so the distance scores here are 1, 1, and 2, so the average of those, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 2 is 4. There's 3 scores, so the average distance would be 1.33. Right? So that's conceptually how you want to think of a standard deviation, although, as you'll find out in a little bit, that's not actually what it is. But whenever you see a standard deviation in a research article or something like that, this is really how you want to think of it, because this is something you can wrap your head around. It turns out that what they actually are is something that's very non-intuitive, and I wouldn't try to understand what those are. I'd just try to think about it as what these are here. So that's basically what a standard deviation is. A variance is basically this exact same thing squared. So like square the 1, square the 2, and you take the average of those. That's what the variance is. So it's a pretty non-intuitive idea itself. It's actually, so if this were inches, if it were measuring heights, for example, standard deviation is in the regular units that the original measures are in. Variance would be in inches squared. So they're really hard to understand. So we could call this is the average of the squared deviation scores. All right, so there's different formulas for these, and there's different formulas depending on whether or not your data set is a population or a sample. So let's start with a simpler one. Let's say that this is a population, right? So then the symbol for variance is lowercase sigma squared. Oof, right? Remember, whenever we're talking about populations, this is the population variance is sigma squared, and its formula. So it's the same thing here. So we have to add up all the squared deviations and divide by the total number to get their average. All right, so for that, I take each score, subtract the mean. And since this is a population, remember, the population mean is the symbol, the Greek letter mu. Right, so we're going to calculate that deviation squared, and we're going to take the average. We need to add up all of them and divide by the number of scores that there are. And this formula is going to be used over and over in this class, so it's really good to get good practice with it, use it a bunch, and become proficient with it, because it's not going away at all. Although usually we'll do the sample version, which we'll talk about in a second. But let's calculate the variance of a population with these scores, a 1, 1, and a 4. Right? So the mean, whether it's a sample or a population, the score, the formula is the same. So the mean will be 2. So then we have to do this for each score. So for the first score is 1 minus the mean of 2. Squared, and then we do that for the next score, also a 1. 1 minus the mean of 2 squared. And we do that for the third score, 4. 4 minus the mean of 2 squared. And if we had more scores in our population, we'd have to add one of these for every score. And then we divide it by the number of scores. There's 1, 2, 3 scores, so 3 goes on the bottom. All right, so 1 minus 2 is negative 1 squared. Same thing again. 4 minus 2 is 2 squared. All this will be divided by 3. Bring it around over here. Negative 1 times negative 1 is 1. Same for here. 2 times 2 is 4. It's going to be divided by 3. 1 plus 1 is 2 plus 4 is 6 divided by 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2. So 2 is our variance. Our population variance is 2. So if this is what the population is, the variance is 2. The standard deviation for this population is pretty easy to calculate once we have the variance. And what I'll do is I'll leave up the result there, because that's going to be useful in a second. So the formula for the standard deviation, the standard deviation symbol, so the population standard deviation, the symbol for that is sigma. So they're exactly the same, except for this one's squared and this one's not. The formula is exactly the same, except for this one, you take the square root. So another way to write this formula is to say that, so this is the exact same formula here, except for you add the square root. So we could actually just take this and take its square root. And so whenever you're calculating the standard deviation, you have to calculate the variance on the way. So in this case, it's easy for us to calculate the population standard deviation now. So we just have to plug in 2 for the variance, take its square root, and the square root of 2 is 1.41. So the population standard deviation, 1.41. Notice this was a little bit different than the actual calculated average distance score, which was 1.33. And it's because you square all those differences rather than taking just the average of them without squaring them. All right, so these are the formulas when you're working with the population itself. You have every person in the population as part of your data set. You're not missing any scores. You're not working with a sample. You've done a census and measured everybody. So in this case, we're only interested in these three people. More commonly, in psychology, we have a sample, which is a subset, so there'd be more people in the population, but we only have access to these four. And so what we're going to do now, since we don't know the population, all the numbers in the population, what we're going to do is we're going to use our sample data to estimate, to guess the population's standard deviation. right? So there's a slight modification of the formula that happens in this case, right? So now we're going to calculate the sample variance, and its symbol is S squared. It's got a very similar formula. It is the same on top, except for you use the sample mean rather than the population mean, and divide it by n minus 1 rather than n. So that'll end up making this value a little bit larger than this because the bottom is smaller and the tops are identical. So we'll calculate this. Maybe I'll put this 2 here. And likewise, I'll put this 1.41 there. Okay, so we'll calculate the sample variance. So the sample mean is 2. We already calculated that. All right, so we got, we'll go through all of our scores. We got 1 minus the mean squared plus the next score is another 1. 1 minus the mean squared plus 4 minus the mean squared. And the bottom is now n minus 1, and there's 1, 2, 3 scores. So it's 3 minus 1, okay? 1 minus 2 is negative 1 squared. 1 minus 2 is negative 1 squared. 4 minus 2 is 2, and that will be squared 2 squared. Divided by 3 minus 1 is 2. Remember, for the population, this was 3, so we didn't subtract that 1. So it's a little bit different. All right, so negative 1 squared is 1. Negative 1 squared is 1. 2 squared is 4 divided by 2. 6 divided by 2. 3 is the sample's variance. That is to say, with this sample data, we estimate that the population's variance is 3. Although if we would have directly calculated it, we'd have learned that it was 2. So, and the reason that happens, just in a very general sense, is the sample is going to be not accurate because we don't know which individuals from the population we have. And generally, it's actually going to be an underestimate if we used this formula. And so somebody figured out that if you modify the formula a little bit, that increases it from like 2 to 3, and the 3 turns out to be a pretty accurate estimate of the population when it truly is a random sample from the population. All right, so the sample variance is going to be 3. I'll erase this stuff and put the 3 over here. Okay. Last we have the sample. Standard deviation. This is S, so it's again very similar to sample variance, but it's not squared. And its formula is going to be just like it was for the sample. Except for again, we're going to take n minus 1. So x minus sample mean squared divided by n minus 1 square root. Of course, you could rewrite this like we did before. This is also the square root of the variance. The variance was 3, so we take the square root of 3. Sample standard deviation, square root of 3, 1.73. And this, of course, is a little bit larger than this because 3 is larger than 2. And this is, based on our sample, our best guess at what the population's standard deviation is. The best guess at how far the scores spread out away from the mean. And so if this is what our actual sample data looked like, we would guess that our scores on average were almost 2 away from the mean. Of course, when we calculated it for real, it was 1.33 distances of these scores from the mean. So this ended up being a little bit larger, and again, that's because you're squaring these before you take the square root. And in practice, this is what you see. sample, standard deviation, because we don't work with populations, we work with samples, so that's the kind of data we have. And so we end up using this formula. SPSS only uses this formula. And a research paper will report the standard deviation because it's way more understandable than the variance. And so sometimes the sample standard deviation is S. You'll also see it as SD. This is what you'd usually see in a research paper, and this is what you'll see in a stats class like this, the Latin letter S.